name is Derek. Today we are making donuts and I'll take you through what we're doing today. We are warming the milk because we don't want our donuts to be dry or crunchy. We just want them to be soft and fluffy. We'll use the mandazi flour. We'll use 2 cups of mandazi flour. Dried good first because it's easier that way for them to gel well and to blend. So we'll go with 1 tablespoon of dried yeast, and then we'll mix with 2 tablespoons of icing sugar, and then we mix it gradually. So the wet ingredients. We'll whisk it thoroughly, and then we can mix other ingredients later. We'll pour in our warm milk. We're using unsalted butter because for me, I feel like the unsalted butter has more flavor compared with the salted one, and it tastes better. And then we'll mix in our dried ingredients. We'll put 1/8 of salt to the wet ingredients until the butter melts. Now this is time we can put our vanilla extract. So we'll put 2 tablespoons. The reason why we're putting vanilla extract basically is to bring out more flavor and tastes so that you can enjoy the donut. Once you've finished mixing the wet ingredients, I'll start putting in a bit of flour as I continue to whisk till it gels properly. I'll start with 1/4 cup. Molding it by hand is better so that you can feel the mixture. I don't know, I just feel more comfortable doing with hand because the whisker can't do much from here onwards. If the dough is too soft and too soggy, you add more flour. You can measure with your eyes if you're comfortable or confident. If not, you can use a cup to do so. So for me, I'll just go with my eyes. I think that should be enough. Taste it and see if we'll add sugar for taste. Then we let it rest for 15 minutes. Then we'll take this from there. We'll dust off our wax surface, just a bit, okay. And my rolling pin as well. like doing it that way so that you can have a smooth transition when I'm doing my rolling. Okay, come on. Good girl. Let's do this. We roll it around till 1 centimeter basically, and then from there we'll cut it round. As you roll it, don't put too much pressure on the dough because it's soft to do. So it's easier that way, and your donuts will come out just perfect as they're supposed to be. Then we start making our small circles. Not too far apart. Small bottle cup to make a small hole in between. One. The excess you put it on the side and then we'll use it for later. Cover them so that they don't dry, and then we'll roll this other one and do the same process again. Still leave this another mandazi. But what we can do, we'll just slice it in the middle, put whatever stuffing you want to put in. If you want to put meat, put meat. Depends with you. Follow me. We have an outside kitchen. For experiment, it's hot. It's fine. And then we'll flip them after a minute. Slide them away from your fingers so that you don't burn yourself. the last batch. These are the round donuts without the hole.